Good evening. I'm going to call to order our regular meeting of Tuesday, November 1st. Madam Clerk, will you confirm posting and roll call?
Mayor, this meeting has been posted in accordance with the Nevada Open Meeting Law. All members of the council, with the exception of Councilwoman March, are present, and you have a quorum.
Thank you. This evening, first I have to remind everybody that these meetings are being video recorded and streamed live to the web. This evening, our invocation will be given by Reverend Lee Steyer from the Henderson Presbyterian Church. And following the invocation, we will have the Pledge of Allegiance. Reverend?
And this evening, Lord, I ask for guidance for the mayor, the city council members, the other officials here of the city as they meet and to do the work of this city. I pray also for all those that are speaking at tonight's meeting that you will guide them as well. Lord, at this time of very important elections, we ask for your guidance in that as well, for discernment for all who have yet to cast their ballots. For all the citizens of this country have been given the opportunity, and more than just the opportunity, but the extreme privilege and responsibility to make our voices heard at the ballot box. We ask you to be with all that are running for various offices and positions, not only here in the city of Henderson, but in Clark County, within the school district, our state, as well as our country, that they all may desire to follow you in their lives and to serve others. Guide us, O Lord, for we ask these things in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice.
Before we get started this evening, I'd like to recognize Troop 564. You young men, would you mind standing so we can see who you are? You're here for your communications merit badge, and we always take just a moment to let all the scouts that come to our city council meetings know how supportive we are of the scouting effort and the principles that it teaches, the values. And we encourage you to go on and get that Eagle rank. And we've made actually a commitment. One of us, if we get invited to your Eagle Court of Honor, we will come to that and present you with a certificate. So I hope you will go on and do that. And I think it'd be great to recognize these young men and their leaders at this time. Thank you. So you guys can sit down now if you'd like. And you can stay for the whole meeting. Sometimes, though, we go till like 2 o'clock in the morning, but you don't have to either if you don't want to. Mr. Murnan, will you, are there any changes? There are some changes to this agenda, isn't there? Would you go over those changes with us?
Certainly, Your Honor. There's been a request to pull item C8 for discussion. Item CA12 has been withdrawn at the request of staff. Item CA13 has been withdrawn at the request of staff. And there's been a request to continue UB21 until the November 14th, 2016 meeting.
Okay. Any changes at the dais? If not, a motion to accept would be in order.
I'll make that motion.
So, on that motion, please cast your votes and post. The agenda motion passes. The agenda is approved.
Item PR1 is a presentation, Breast Cancer Awareness Month. At this time, I would like to ask Dan Pentowski, president of the Henderson Professional Firefighters, and Zach Davis of the Henderson Firefighters Benevolent Association to come to the podium. October has been recognized as Breast Cancer Awareness Month since 1985. To help raise awareness in our community, Henderson firefighters wore Go Pink for the Cure shirts while on duty during October. Through the sales of Go Pink for the Cure shirts, Henderson firefighters also raised donations for BCRF, the Breast Cancer Research Foundation. BCRF's mission is focused on cancer prevention and finding a cure for breast cancer by funding innovative research. For the third year, Henderson firefighters open t-shirt sales to the general public. Proceeds are shared equally between the BCRF and the Henderson Firefighters Benevolent Association. a nonprofit organization established by Henderson firefighters to provide charitable assistance to its members, the public, and local community outreach organizations throughout Southern Nevada. Representatives from the Henderson Professional Firefighters and Henderson Firefighters Benevolent Association will now share a summary of this year's efforts in support of Breast Cancer Awareness Month.
And before they do that, I would just like to thank them. Every year, for as long as I can remember, you've been very supportive, and so we appreciate your efforts on this, and then I'm going to let you guys kind of tell us what's going on.
Perfect. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
My name is Zach Davis. I work for Henderson Fire Department, also part of the Henderson Benevolent Association. Last month for breast cancer, we raised a total of $1,200 for t-shirt sales, and that money goes to Breast Cancer Research Foundation. As you can see right now, people are starting to have mustaches as well for the month of November, and that's another great opportunity for us to raise money. That's another great opportunity to support the men like we did for the women, and just show the loved ones that go through this that we know, because our family is very extended, obviously, and within the city and our department that we support the loved ones who have to go through cancer. So we just want to say that the appreciation of the t-shirts is an awareness. The money is to help to support and find a cure, but for the month of November, you'll see mustaches probably don't fit most of our faces, or t-shirts with mustaches on it, and that's just to bring awareness for the men as well, to support them. On top of that, Chief Morris has been just an absolute outstanding help for us in supporting us, and this is the first year also that we have military shirts for the month of November. Very much like the NFL, we'll have camo on our shirts for the month of November, raising money for the Veterans of Foreign War, and bringing support for the ones who give such a great sacrifice for us. So we want to say a big thank you to Chief Morris, to all the council who supports him, and then obviously Mayor, you as well. Thank you for supporting us, and we will continue to support you as well. So thank you.
Thank you, Zach.
Sir.
Next item on your agenda is the City Manager's Report. City of Henderson Community Development Services Director Stephanie Garcia-Voss and city staff visited with Travis Davey and C.T. Stuhl Elementary School students after donating two garden beds, a variety of edible plants, trees, and a garden. The donated items were used in demonstrations at a recently hosted U.S. Environmental Protection Agency workshop to explore healthy food solutions in downtown Henderson. City staff is thrilled that this donation will help expand the amazing garden program at C.T. Sewell Elementary School and promote access to fresh food. Please join us this Saturday, November 5th, for the annual Henderson Veterans Day Ceremony. The ceremony is being held at the Henderson Events Plaza, adjacent to the Veterans Memorial Wall outside City Hall. Our Veterans Day Ceremony honors all those Americans who have shown a commitment to protecting our nation through their military service. This event features a keynote address from Colonel Paul J. Murray of the U.S. Air Force Station at Nellis Air Force Base. The Basic High School Marine Corps JROTC will conduct the presentation of colors and read the names to be added to the memorial wall, and the Henderson Symphony Orchestra will provide a special musical tribute. We look forward to seeing the community gather to salute our veterans on Saturday morning. I'm pleased to announce that the City's Public Works, Parks, and Recreation Department has received a World Water Park Association's 2016 Kelly Ogle Memorial Safety Award for its outstanding community outreach, water safety education, comprehensive learning to swim classes, and year-round drowning prevention programs. Our most recent successful outreach efforts focus directly on the children and families. The city's aquatics team has reached more than 10,000 children in school and daycare centers, teaching the ABCs and Ds of drowning prevention. In addition, Walk and Knock, a collaboration between the city's Public Works, Parks and Recreation, and fire departments, is a door-to-door campaign that reinforces safe water habits. To date, more than 5,000 educational flyers have been hand-delivered to Henderson homes. So great work for all those involved in getting the word out on water safety. And that concludes manager's report. The next section of your agenda is the consent agenda. Consent agenda constitutes items CA2 through CA19. As a reminder, CA8 has been pulled for discussion, and CA12 and CA13 have been withdrawn.
All right, so far, City Manager said, CA8 has been pulled for discussion. If no item is pulled for discussion on the consent agenda, then we will approve those items with one motion. I don't have any others in the audience at the dais. If not, motion to approve the consent agenda would be in order.
Mayor, I'll move to approve the consent agenda with the amendments.
All right. So with that, cast your votes and post. The motion carries. The consent agenda is approved.
Item CA8 is a retainer agreement for legal services, Peterson Hope. Recommendation is to approve.
Mayor and Council, Josh Reed, City Attorney. This agreement for legal services is with the law firm of Peterson Hope. The purpose of this agreement, we had used one of the principals of Peterson Hope, Tammy Peterson, on a litigation matter for several years, and she has left her current firm to start her own law firm, and so this agreement will allow us to continue to use her and her firm on future matters. Just a reminder, we bring these agreements pursuant to the city's fiscal signature policy. This agreement isn't for a specific amount. The city attorney's office is budgeted a certain amount each year for outside counsel. Over the past 5 years, we've used between 20 and 29% of that amount. So we're a good steward of those funds, and we see it as an insurance bank if things go south on us. And accordingly, right now we only have one matter with outside counsel, litigation matter with outside counsel and their co-counsel. And so most of our litigation is handled in-house.
And just for clarification, so that line item in your budget is the amount that's budgeted for the complete year, not necessarily is going to be
That is the unencumbered amount. And so actually what's budgeted each year is about $1.2 million. Okay. But we encumber a certain amount, and so that's the at the time this agenda item was created, the unencumbered amount
available. Okay. So, Crystal, you asked this item to be pulled for discussion.
Hi, Crystal Hendrickson, 478 Crestway Road. What made us choose the Henderson, I guess you answered some of my questions up till now. But it appears that it did not go out to bid. Is that correct?
No. Normally, professional services agreements do not go out for bid. We've done that before, but this one we did not.
Okay. So it looks like Peterson Hope specializes in commercial and high-stakes litigation. So there's a current lawsuit out there that we have outside counsel doing. What is that for?
The matter that she's been working on for several years actually just resolved about a month ago. It was a police matter that was resolved, we think, successfully for the city. The other matter that we have with outside counsel where their co-counsel is a construction case, a contractor case, kind of a construction defect case from 2011.
Okay. I wanted to know more about the Peterson Hope Law Firm. So here's what I uncovered. So Peterson currently serves on the board of the Southern Nevada Better Business Bureau. Better Business Bureau accreditation is only offered to businesses that have been in business for over a year. They require that members abide by their code of ethics, including truthfulness, integrity, honesty, and transparency. The Better Business Bureau website indicates that Peterson Hope has been an accredited business since 2003, even though their articles of incorporation were filed with the Secretary of State only 5 short months ago. Also, according to Peterson's own LinkedIn account, she is a founding partner of Peterson Hope, beginning in June 2016. Peterson Hope is not an established firm. They've just opened their doors for business. They don't have a website. They aren't members of the Henderson Chamber of Commerce. They don't have a Henderson office. They don't have a Henderson business license. They don't even have a Clark County business license in their name. The only business license registered to their address at 10001 Park Run Drive is registered to Marquis Arbach Coffing Law Firm. And as a contractor, I have to have a business license in every jurisdiction I do business in. Don't private attorneys doing work for the city have to abide by the same laws? So what I really want to know is, I mean, I see you've used these people before. It appears that Tamara Peterson, Nikki Baker Hope, and Josh Reed all worked at Brownstein, Hyatt, Farber, Schreck together. They're old friends, cronies. That's how citizens define cronyism. People in high places using public dollars to reward their friends. You know, whatever happened to your guiding principles? Live where you work, shorter commutes, and supporting Henderson-based businesses. Peterson Hope is 28 miles away, and we're paying them $350 an hour plus travel expenses. With over a quarter million residents in Henderson, you think we could find a qualified local attorney. This isn't the private sector here. We hold public officials to a different standard. When you work for the taxpayer, you shouldn't expect us to pay for your lunch and do business with your favorite people.
Mayor, may I just...
No, I move to approve this retainer agreement for legal services. Please cast your votes on that motion. And post. Motion passes. Mr. Murnan.
Item B20 is bill number 3100, amend Henderson Municipal Code section 4.36.040 of chapter 4.36, liquor regulations and licenses. I believe the city attorney would like to make some corrections to that item.
Yes. Apologize, Josh Reed, city attorney. There was new backup that you've all been handed out just now. They're just some small corrections. They're all highlighted in yellow. Essentially, we're changing, and there's some of the provisions where the word section was used when it should have said subsection, and those are found in subsection J1, J2A, J6A, J6B, and J7A. And again, all of these are highlighted in yellow.
Okay, the proper action is to refer bill number 3100 to the committee meeting of November 14th for discussion, along with those additions. That'll be my motion. Cast your votes on that motion and post. Motion passes.
Item UB21 has been continued. Item UB22 is bill number 3099, amend Henderson Municipal Code section 2.04, council meetings. Recommendation is to adopt as ordinance number 3368.
That'll be my motion. Please cast your votes on that motion and post. Motion carries.
Item MB23 is 2017 RDA and City Council meeting schedule. Recommendation is to approve.
There's no discussion. I'll move that we approve that schedule for 2017. Cast your votes on that motion and post. Motion carries.
Item MB24 is a resolution and notice of intent to lease 345 square feet of office space located in Henderson City Hall to the Southern Nevada Health District. Recommendation is to adopt as resolution number 4236.
Here, I'll make that motion.
Okay, so we have a motion on the floor. Cast your votes and post. Motion carries.
Item MB25 is a resolution and notice of intent to lease 211 Water Street and 219 B, C, and D Water Street to Joan Dung Lim, an individual doing business as the Lotus Restaurant. Recommendation is to adopt as resolution number 4237.
That will be my motion. There's no discussion. Cast your votes on that motion and post. Motion carries.
Next section of your agenda, Mayor and Council Member comments.
The only comment, and I will make this again at the end of the meeting, we are moving our regular meeting, which would have generally been on November 15th, to Monday, November 14th. So the next item is to set our committee meeting, and so that's why our committee meeting will be set for 5:45 p.m. on Monday, November 14th, 2016. We've now come to the public comment portion of our agenda. We have no yellow cards. Is there anyone in the audience that would like to address us? Now would be the time to do that. If not, then this meeting is adjourned. Thank you.